God will surprise somebody here today. Heaven will surprise somebody this year. If you are the one I am talking to, get up and shout amen. If that message is for you, and you believe it's for you, wherever you are, then jump up and shout amen. You may be seated.
Beginning from verse 4 to 9. For personal consumption, you take note of Psalm 126 and 2 Kings chapter 19, 20 to 25.
Luke chapter 5, 4 to 9. Now, when they are not speaking, he said unto Simon, look out into the deep and let down your net for a draught. Simon answered and said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, I will let down the net. And when they have done this, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net broke, and they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled the ships, so that they began to sink. When Simon Peter saw it, he fell down, saying, depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. But he was astonished, and all who were with him, at the draught of the fishes which they had taken. Father, as we gather before you, for anyone that will echo amen, give him a divine surprise package. This is 2016. Last year is gone. For anyone that will echo another amen, they have been waiting for something that will amaze them. They have been looking at Ikaim, oh God, yearning for something that will make them be astonished. Positive things.
I declare on this altar today, whoever echo amen, let them be divine surprises. Yeah. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' name we pray. We are talking about divine surprises. Of course, in English,
word divine is God,
the Trinity,
that which is bigger than the natural, divine. If somebody asks you a question, if the divine decides to visit you, and a mortal man chooses to visit you, among these two, which one will you welcome? If you will welcome the divine, wave your hand, let me see. Wave it again. Waving your hands, you are embarrassing the devil. By waving your hands, you are waving away sickness. By waving your hands, you are waving away police case. By waving your hands, you are waving away untimely death. By waving your hands, you are waving away accident. By waving your hands, you are waving away policy. And
if you wave your double hands, goodness and mercy, supply from the throne of grace, shall be your portion.
When we talk about surplus from the Oxford Dictionary, it defines surplus, surprise, an unexpected or astonishing event, fact, to cause someone to feel amazed at something. We are talking about an unexpected event, an astonishing event, something that comes to you and you are surprised. How many? As you are looking at me this morning, you are from a less privileged home. Somebody decides to come to you. In your father's house, nobody have a ride a car. Then somebody walked into your bedroom and said, my brother. Meanwhile, the man being addressed is a bricklayer. And right there, somebody walked to you and said, guess. You ask, what do I guess? What should I guess? He said, keep guessing. Just guess. Keep guessing. He said, close your eyes. Open your palm. Don't open your eye. Then he placed something in your hand. With his hand still is on top of your hands. He said, what can you guess what I want to, I'm about placing in your hand? He said, well, maybe you want to give me 5 naira or 10 naira. He said, no, not 20 naira, not 30 naira. What you have been guessing, your assumption last year and the beginning of this year, the Lord shall bring it to pass. Then suddenly, he dropped a key and asked you to open your eyes. And you open your eyes and you saw key for a brand new car. What do you call that one? Would you be surprised? He said, hey, sir, please, who owns this? You. Divine surprises. God is going to surprise somebody here. This year is the year of the Lord. The year the cacaworm, caterpillar worm, palm worm has eaten. I hear the voice of the Lord. As I was praying concerning this message, in the night I had a revelation and I was addressing you and I was saying, look at what the Lord is about to do. And somebody stood up and said, it is me. And I told the person, the realm of the spirit is going to be your own. So for anyone that will echo amen, God will surprise you this year. Now, there are negative surprises and there are positive ones. The negative ones, let us give an example. For example, somebody phone you. Hello? Have you heard what happened? What is it? Mr. ABCD is dead. Right there you are shocked. It amazes you. We saw yesterday now. We are together now. What must have killed him? Aren't you surprised? You are surprised because yesterday both of you ate together. Isn't it? But only to receive an ugly story. A call. Look at what has happened. For anyone that will echo amen, that is not your own. Then when we are talking of the positive ones. For example, a woman has been believing God for the fruit of the womb. 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. Until a time, she just say, I bet make I forget. Who no get picking, he dey live. In a time when she's not even thinking of having a child, not too long, a month passing by. My husband, I've not seen my period. First month, second month, third month, fourth month, fifth month. The husband right there will be shocked. We have never seen it like this before. That is what the Lord wants to do this year. God will surprise you. He will surprise your enemies. Before we go to the place we have read, even God can surprise your enemies. How? Israel were to fight Goliath or the Philistines. And they look for a man that will come and confront Goliath and nobody. And behold, a small boy was just coming with catapult and stone. And Goliath looked at him and said, who are you? He was shocked. He was surprised. Goliath was surprised. Your enemy shall be surprised. God will surprise your enemy. What is about to do in your life this year? I didn't hear your amen like a thunder. In Exodus chapter 3, Moses was taking care of his father-in-law's flock or sheep. While he was taking care of it and so on, what happened? The Lord wanted to draw the attention of Moses. Right where the Lord stood, there was a bush there. The bush was engulfed by fire. The bush was being burned. The fire was burning the bush. But the bush itself was not consumed. But because God wanted to draw the attention of Moses, Moses said, hey, look, see bush burning. See fire burning a bush. But the bush itself is not consumed. And Moses' attention was drawn. He has never seen it before. What you have never witnessed before. That thing that has never happened to you before. That testimony you are here to tell or narrate. glorious manifestation of the power of God that has never happened in your family before. That thing you've been longing for and anticipating, asking the Lord, when shall be the appointed time? You said in your word that vision is for an appointed time. Although it tarry, wait for it, for it shall surely come to pass. Anyone that get up to take this word, that vision shall come to pass. Sit down. There are other places in the scripture where God revealed his glory and brought divine surprises. One of those notable places is Psalm 126. In Psalm 126, Sennacherib, the king of Assyria, invaded Samaria and took away the Israelites. Not too long, he invaded Judah or Jerusalem. And that coincided with the time when Hezekiah was the king in Jerusalem. And he came, I have taken over Samaria. It is now your town, Jerusalem. He asked his boys, called Rabshakeh, the commander of his army, go and tell them, I invaded Samaria. I took away them as captives, and I've taken this one as captives. I have covered this nation. I have conquered this nation. I have conquered this nation. I have conquered this nation. It is now your turn. The people, the servant of the king, Hezekiah, carried the message back to Hezekiah, and Hezekiah wept. Stand to your feet and take this. Anything that will make you to weep this year is canceled. If you want to take it, take it. That which will make you to weep this year, whether from papa's side, mama's side, in your business, in your profession, that will make you to cry this year, as you echo amen before the angels of God, before the Holy Trinity, it is canceled in Jesus' name. Sit down. The Bible says, and they came to Hezekiah, and Hezekiah prayed. They took the letter before God and read it before God. That is what informs Psalm 126, because Psalm 126 has no author. And theologians or Bible historians will say it is linked to that particular event. As they besieged the land of Jerusalem, what happened? The Lord sent message through Isaiah. Go back and tell Hezekiah, I am going to release a blast. Can somebody give me a blast voice? Let me hear you. Help me tell somebody this year there is going to be a blast. Tell somebody God will release a blast this year. He did not hear you. Tapa! God will release a blast this year. I am going to send the king Sennacherib a message. A message of no return. They surrendered the whole land of the land of Judah, and they were crying, shall we follow our brother into captivity? This is the remnant, and this one I remain. Shall God also take us away into captivity? And while they were contemplating, Hezekiah was praying, others were praying. One night the Lord released one angel, and the angel with a mighty sword, moving from houses to houses, from tent to tent, in the camp of the Assyria. And before you know, before they break, that angel slaughtered and slew 185,000 soldiers of Assyria. Is that not a surprising thing? Talk to me now. Is that not surprising? Then the place where we have read, it has to do with Peter. Peter happened to be a professional fisherman. He knows every nooks and crannies where you can throw a net and get fish. He's been in that business for years and days and months. But one fateful day, this man and his other of his colleagues went out to fish and they caught nothing. Your trap must catch this year. May that your amen be born again. Your trap must catch this year. There is this man whose name is called Frederick Hangel. George Frederick Hangel. He's a German. He was a German. When this man was born in 17th century, God gave him a talent. And that talent was very, very useful. He was a musician. He wrote many gospel music. He wrote it until one day he became so famous. He became so rich. After some time, the enemy attacked him. He was, part of his body here became paralyzed. He could not talk. He couldn't write. Towards it, he was a debtor, a notorious debtor. He owed this one, he owed this one, he owed this one, he owed this one. Get ready! This year, you shall not be a debtor. For every debt in your life, as you get up to say amen, it is canceled, it is canceled. It is canceled, it is canceled, it is canceled. It is canceled. Wait, remain standing. Remain standing. It was that small boy that brought two fishes. Five loaves of bread, two fishes to Christ. After Jesus blessed it, he said, distribute them. And they did. And after spreading everything, they were having leftover. Ask me, the leftover goes to who? That small boy. That before the boy died, of course he grew to become a mature man having children, but before he died he became a multi-billionaire. Is that not a surprising thing? Tell somebody, God will surprise you. He did not hear you. Tell him, God will surprise you. Tell him, I'm telling you because I'm a child of God. He did not hear you. I prophesy into your life this year. He didn't hear you. Tell him, I invoke blessing into your life. I vomit blessing into your life. That which you have prayed for 21 days, I vomit answers to prayer. I vomit grace and glory. I vomit testimony. I vomit divine surprises. Anything you do, surprises. Anywhere you go, surprises. Whatever you are doing, surprises. In your business, surprises. There shall be divine manifestation and divine surprises. God will cover your nakedness. He will cover your nakedness. Tell him, he will cover. Abel shall cover your nakedness. Remain standing. And what happened? The man became so sick. He could not write. Until a man came to him and told him, George, Andrew, you've been in this condition for many years. Why not sum up courage and write another gospel song? Since they know you as a gospeler, as a gospel artist, and you have written many songs from the Bible, or you are managed again. And the man said, my hands couldn't move. I have problem here. I can't talk well, unlike before. But because you said it, because you have challenged me to go back to the master, the author and the finisher of my faith, I will try. And when he summed up courage, strength came. And when strength came, before you know, partial stroke disappeared. Is that not a surprising thing? Let me tell 11 persons, if you not believe before, believe now. God will surprise you this year. Tell him God will surprise you. Listen though, before you have your seat. Look at me. Never you be ashamed of what you have passed through last year. What I heard God said, he will use your story of last year to bring glory to his name this year. And the man became well. And power came into his hand. And he started writing again another gospel songs. Lift up your right hand. Lift it up. Divine surprises. Divine surprises. As you lift up your hand, divine surprises. What I never thought of. I have already given up. I have told myself, I'm not going to wahala my head again. I don't forget. I know they remember again. That time, I don't even remember. I never anticipated. All those times, I have forgotten. God will bring surprise into your life. Sit down. I have a few minutes. Look at me. There is oil on this head.
And I want to say one or two things, and therefore I pray with you. Because there's going to be divine surprises. Peter, when Jesus met him, you have turned from money till now. Any fish? He said, no. You have not caught anyone? He said, no. Okay, leave this side. Throw your net to this other side. You will catch fish. Peter said, oh God, no. I'm a professional fisherman. I've been in this business for long. There are times fishes come out, you catch them. But at this particular time, you can't catch again. No more time. I've been inside this business and I know the ideal time to catch fish. For this particular time, you can't catch. No time. Jesus said, no. You obey. God is full of surprises. When men are down in their faith and they thought that that nothing good can come out, that is the time God will manifest his glory. When men are discouraged and say, I am about to give up, that is the time he show forth his glory and his power. Peter, obey. Cast your net to this other side. Peter said, well, if another man had told me this, I will not listen. If any other person had come and tell me, say this and so on. You see, look at me. They know you as John last year. And they compare your status and say you cannot rise above this level. The brothers of Job, were they not surprised? The brothers of Joseph, were they not surprised? Joseph came and told them, I have a dream. We were inside the field. My chef arose and I saw your own bow before my own. They said, God forbid, Awabua. Another time he came, I saw the star, the moon, fall down and worship me. They say, his father said, even me, your papa, God forbid. But what said the scripture? In Genesis 45, when God lifted up Joseph, and this time his brothers were there, they came to buy grain or corn. At the first instance, he pretended as if he did not know them. But when they saw him, they bowed before him. Men shall bow to you this year. Thrones shall bow to you this year. Evil altar shall disappear for your sake this year. Anything bad that will not give God the glory shall see you and bow this year. Excuse me, your father's house shall worship you. Your mother's house shall worship you. They will recognize the grace and glory you carry. You will not fall, but they will fall for you. As you lift up your hands to take this under this auction, that thing that you have been trusting the Lord for, this year shall come to pass. There shall be surprises there. Surprises there. Surprises there. Surprises there. Divine surprises. Divine package. Divine testimony. Divine covenant. Divine strength. Divine glory. Divine joy. Divine peace. Divine good news. It shall be your portion. The loudest amen. Take it. It's your portion. Take it. The loudest amen. 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 Take it. So shall it be. Your amen shall bring it to pass. By the power of God, so shall it be. When the angels, Gabriel told Mary, you are highly favored, daughter of God. You are going to conceive the Holy Seed. Mary said, she became surprised. She was amazed. I'm a virgin. How will this thing be? I have never known any man. She said, no, this is divine package that will introduce you and make everybody to hear your name, Mary, mother of God. She concluded by saying, let it be so to me according to your word. Can somebody lift up your hand and say, God, let it be so to me according to your word. When the brothers of Joseph came and they saw this time around, he became so emotional. He asked all his servants, leave here, leave here. And he was left alone with his brothers.
He wept before them. He looked at Reuben. Oh, in his mind, Joseph must have said, Reuben, you were the one that God used to brought me out from that particular pit I was thrown to. Judah, Levi, Issachar, and so on and so forth. Look at them. They were looking at him. They were astonished. Then later, when they saw him weeping, he cannot control himself. He looked for handkerchief. He must have looked for handkerchief. He cleansed the tears on his face. Then thereafter, they were expecting to hear something that will perhaps make them to be happy. But when he said, I am out of 11. None of them could recognize him. That is very bad. Well, don't blame them, because it's long. The Joseph they knew by then was a slave that was sold, a small boy. But the one now standing before them, they don't even know him. He dressed like a big man, was a big man, second in command. I am. Somebody is here. God is about to rewrite your story. I am Joseph, your brother. Is my father still alive? They were surprised. Joseph. The senior look at him. Tall, he's taller than them. In handsomeness, more than them. In the clothes, they all put on. His own has no rival. Joseph. They all look at him. They were shocked. Any man that want to take this thing. They don't to bobo you. They don't to trouble you. You know they get rest of mind. You they overcome this one, another problem they come. This year, get ready on your mark. Get set. This year, you will go forward. Wait, oh, now you they define. They say nothing good can come out from Nazareth. Get ready. God will surprise your enemies this year.
Amen.
When they are waiting for you to fall down, the Bible said, then there shall be a lifting up.
Yes.
When they are waiting for you to cry, the Lord will put a new song in your mouth.
Yes.
When they are waiting for you to fall down, you will keep rising.
Yes.
When they are waiting for your obituary, God will add more years to your year. When they are waiting for you to be sorrowful, He will put a song in your leg.
Yes.
He will put a dance at your feet.
Yes.
Weeping may endure for a night.
But joy,
call in the morning. You are in your season of glorious manifestation. You are in your year of season of blessing. May I prophesy to somebody glorious and divine surprises.
Yes.
I see divine packages.
Hallelujah.
Coming to your life.
Hallelujah.
Barren womb shall conceive. Your marriage is due this year.
Amen.
You will wear your wedding garment.
Amen.
This year, your job, you will get it.
Amen.
Promotion is coming to your profession.
Amen.
This year, they shall look for you for good.
Amen.
You will not cry. You will sing a new song.
Amen.
Why? It is divine surprises.
Amen.
Divine surprises. Divine surprises. Look at me, gentlemen and ladies. Are you there with your Bible? Hold your Bible. Lift it up. Lift up your Bible. Lift it up. Lift up your Bible. What is that thing in your hand? Come on, what are you holding in your hand? Lift it up and say, my father, with my Bible in my hand, I will obey everything inside this Bible this year. I will pay my tithe this year. I will live a holy life this year. I will love my brother and my sister this year. I will not keep grudges in my mind this year. As I lift up my Bible, let there be divine surprises. I have 7 minutes more. Look here. As you were standing, the Bible says, Peter said, because you have said so, I will obey, because you said so. And as they threw the net to the other side, what happened? He caught fishes. unnumbered fishes, innumerable fishes, multitude of fishes. They drag it until their net break, and they beckon others, come and help us. The fish is here over, they are too much. We have never seen this type since I became a professional fisherman. What you have never witnessed before as a pastor or as a member, good things before you have never witnessed. Get ready, because this year Jehovah shall embarrass you with good things. And they start dragging it. They start dragging it. They couldn't. Others came and they team up their forces. They had strength on strength, and they were dragging it, pulling it. I guess along the line, somebody must have fallen, because the numbers of fishes inside that net, they have never seen it before. This is what some fishermen, it will take 10 years for fishermen. If you catch one this year, two next year, 3 years, put together, it will take 10 years. God is giving somebody only one day. The Bible says the battle is not meant for the swift, nor the race meant for the strong, but time and chance happen to them all. This is my time, oh God, and this is my chance this year. Your chance has come, your time has come, your chance has come. Wherever you are, as you jump up to say amen, take your own blessing divine, take your own surprises, take your own joy, take your own peace, take your own victory, take your own a new song. Take your all is happening there. Take your all in the second step. Take your all over the earth. Look, look. Peter, after dragging me, every one of them, look at sweat all over their body. And they were panting anyhow, like there. Then Peter, look, Jesus. Get away from me. Get away from me. I am a sinner. Get away from me. I never seen this kind of thing before. Oh my God. I go dance this year. I go make your God this year. If I dance and go here, I dance and go here. I dance and go here. I dance and go here. It is over. Over to sickness. Over to untimely death. Over to poison. Over to barrenness, over to carryover, over to academic failure. Your tears has expired. Your barrenness expire. Infertility expire.
He will say to you,
God will promote this year. God will say to you this year.
Say to you this year. He will say to you this year.
Divine surprises. I want to pray. Wait. If an angel enter your house now, as soon as you reach out, as you are about opening the door, or you open the door, before you open, an angel is seated in your parlor. And he wanted to make himself visible. And you see, Jesus. As you want to raise alarm, say, shh, peace be still. If you see an angel like that, won't you be surprised? Won't you be surprised? Wait. You go to your work, and your boss said, you are supposed to be in level 4 by next month. But there's favor on your head. Take. We put you on level 12. Is that one not a surprising thing? God is a specialist when it comes to surprises. He takes men by surprise. And I prophesy and I vomit. By the oil on my head, I vomit on all adult district members here. All aging members looking at me. Whether over the end, second step, the first step, I vomit on you. And as you echo amen, there shall be divine surprises. You were the Wakago Lapogoboro. Lapogo find you come. You where they beg from gutter to gutter, men will look for you. You will not get cloth to wear. God will surprise you. He will give you different cloth. He will give you different shoe. Wave your hands and shout amen. Lift up your two hands. I want to pray. Lift it up and say, God, surprise me. I can't claim your promises. You have taught me divine surprises. Divine surprises. Divine surprises. God will surprise somebody. Oh yeah, come and open your mouth. Oh yeah, vomit it. Oh yeah, say it. Oh yeah, come and vomit it. Oh yeah, say it. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, my God, my God. I claim your divine surprises. My child is sick before. Oh yeah, surprise me this year. He not go sick again. My husband be this, my wife be this. Oh yeah, surprise us this year. Divine surprises. Divine surprises. Divine surprises. Divine surprises. Divine surprises. Lift up that your two hands. In the next 2 minutes, I want to drop the microphone. Anywhere you are, remain standing with your two hands lifted up. Take this. By the oil I carry, by the grace labeled on my forehead, the grace of Jehovah, before the holy angels of God are present here today, and before the Holy Trinity, for anyone that say echo amen, you know their names, you have their particulars with you, you know where they are staying, you know the tribe they come from, but for anyone that will echo amen now, it is divine surprises. Beginning from this month, January, surprises, 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 surprises. February, surprises. March, surprises. April, divine surprises. May, divine surprises. June, divine surprises. July, divine surprises. August, divine surprises. September, divine surprises. October, divine surprises. November, divine surprises. Then when you hear December, look me, look me. I believe in fatherly blessing. By divine privilege, not right, not by power, but by divine privilege, I was asked to be your chief servant. Abi? Which implies that God believes in on the oil he places on my head. So I want to say a word now, finally. And it must come to pass. And the person that that thing will happen to is you. Is you. Is you. You have tore all throughout the night. You have labored like an elephant, always eating like an ant. I am the high priest standing in between you and God. And as you lift up your hands today, beginning from now to December, in the name of him that raised Jesus from the grave, there shall be divine surprises in your life in Jesus' name. Jump up and shout amen. 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 Put your hands to the glory of God. So shall it be. It is well with you.